Hello everybody, my name is George Kouratiadis. I am responsible for R2 Greece Center, and I'm going to give you some clues how our clients and our dentists manage to give to their patient a one day smile. First of all, I want to thank a lot the Minik team for proposing me to make this online lecture. Dr. Simon Marr, who is for me a very good teacher, by assisting to a lot of cases that we have some things with the R2Gate software, and the MegaGen implant for giving me this opportunity. To be honest, it's my first time that I'm doing this, so I apologize if some of the images are not so good, because in most of these cases and surgeries, I was in person there, and I took the photos from my cell phone, and it was not mentioned to do something like that, just making some posts over the social media, promoting our job and our client's job. By normalizing digital, I believe that the meaning is to give to the dentist the opportunity that even they don't have an extraoral CBCT or an intraoral scanner to making everything in-house, giving them the tools and the possibility to make things easier for them. And give to their patient a solution for immediate provisionals the day of the surgery. Most of the cases here are from a general dental surgeon, so this was a little bit challenging, to be honest, to combine their skills, our lab skill techniques. Dr. Michalis Papastamos, dental aesthetic, and our skill in giving them the best solution that we could provide as a dental treatment. The final confirmation of any case that we did and we do is on the dentist, and our part is to accept or reject some cases if all the data are not fulfilled the standards that we have. So, in our first case that took place in Greece was about 4 years ago. It was not from the R2Gate Greece Center. It was supported from the R2Gate Center in Romania, and with the assist of Vlad Hithru and Alexandra. It took place in Athens Perio, Dr. Mambalis Anastasios. It was a simple case, a male patient, age around 50. There were missing two teeth in the lower jaw. So we asked them to manufacture us and send us a surgical guide for two implants and the prosthetics as two element screw retained. We received the surgical guide that is sleeveless. This is what I prefer and I like most in the R2Gate, that we don't have sleeves, so we are more accurate. And we also received the two provisional teeth made by PMMA on TiGen abutment. The design was made. The matching was made by the Romania team, and we take the files, we make all the modifications, and then after the confirmation, we have the surgical guide, which I, as I told, is sleeveless. And here we can see the surgical guide in the mouth of the patient. This is the STL files that the guy sent us from Romania with the provisionals and how they took all the files from the hardware. and these are the screw retained provisionals. We use a surgical guide. We place the implants according to the protocol that they sent us. And here we can see the provisionals with the holes for the screw in the mouth. This was the first case that we did in Greece. And after that, we realized that the possibilities of immediate provisionals from small cases are unlimited. This was the reason that we decided to establish the Artugate Center in Greece, and we were trained on a trip that we did in Korea, and started to promote and encourage our customers, clients, friends, I can say, to use it, because the potentials was unlimited. Even if they don't have, as I said, the digital equipment, we could offer them a lot of possibilities due to the unique design of the software that we use, the Artugate software. It's an open software. It can export STL files that can be printed everywhere, but we print all the surgical guides in our Artu Center, Artu Lab, Dr. Michalis Papastamos, Dental Aesthetic Lab, because we want to control the quality and the accuracy of the guides. But they can use any dental lab that they want to make the provisionals. We can just send them the files, the STL files that are exported from the Artuware, and make the provisionals in there. This was the opportunity that was given to the customers, and after a few cases that we saw them over the internet or make the presentation, they are started to trust us, because there was a lot of failures from other tries with other systems, open or closed, and they were hesitating to trust a software that was just appeared in the market, in the Greek market at least. And it started evolving very, very good, I can say. I will keep the first Artugate Greece case for the end, because instead of doing one or two teeth, we tried four teeth in the fourth quarter of the lower jaw, the second quarter of the lower jaw, and four teeth in the third quarter of the jaw. So one of the cases that we completed lately is the following. It was an edentulous lower jaw. The patient is around 62 years and he has a denture supported on a canine. This is this was a very tricky case, because we decided to keep the canine into the mouth so as to have extra support for our surgical guide, and because the implants will be placed too close to the canine, we didn't want to lose the bone after the extraction. Here is the digital WhatsApp that we get from our R2 lab center. We make the matching to the CBCT and the STL model, and it was perfectly aligned because the patient used a custom R2 tray that was made by our partner R2 lab, Dr. Michalis Papastamos. And here you can see how the implants are fitted into the mouth, into the mouth. This is the initial situation of the dentist, and on the right side you can see the digital WhatsApp that we received and we used in the Artugate software. We make the planning. I have to mention that all of our customers are directly connected to our personal servers, so we don't have to send anything to them. They just open their PC and they see the exact image that we have in front of our screen. So they make all the modifications that they want. They change the implant position in their preferred way. They can adjust even the WhatsApp position if they want, and they just confirm the files, and I get the confirmation files directly to my PC. It was something that we wanted to make much easier, not to open a website, download files or things like that. Of course, Megazyne has the R2K Lite, but it plays only on an iOS tablet, and most of them, they don't have it. So this was the most convenient solution. Just have everybody connecting with us, and when they open their PC, they see the same image as we see. After the digital planning, we have the confirmation file, which is this one, with the implants and the position that the dentist choose. And the fantastic thing of the Artware software is when you are exporting an STL file for the surgical guide, it also exports an STL file with the digital scan abutments. These are the one that you can see on the right image. It's something like we have already placed the implants, and the dentist took his intraoral scanner and he scanned the scan abutments. This is unique because it's this STL is an open file, so by importing it to any software, CAD software like 3Shape or Exoplan or Exocad or Dental Wings, you can have a file that you can make all the adjustment you want. You can replace the abutment with the Easy Post abutments, with Octa abutments, with multi-union abutments, any abutment that you want, even if with pre-milled abutments. So the lab took this file that is also connected to us and designed, firstly, it printed the surgical guide, as you can see, and it, here it's fitting in the mouth. You can see that there is two pins supported and one in the canine. Also, we overlapped the lower jaw so as to have extra stability. In the next photo, you can see that there were placed the four implants in the fourth quarter, full guided. And here are the provisional, here are the temporary abutments already trimmed from the lab. And as you can see, we didn't extract it. The doctor, the dentist decide not to extract the canine, but use the something like the submerged technique to have more stability to the bone and to preserve the mesial bone of the implant that it is next to the canine. And after that, we proceed to the provisionals. As you can see, it is a full CAD/CAM prosthesis. The engagement took place into the mouth of the patient the same day that we placed the implant. You can see that there is a very good result with the provisional that that the doctor choose as a color, and the digital aesthetic Michaelis Papastamos lab produce from him. This is what we believe that normalizing digital is. The patient and Dr. McCarthy's, after the surgery, they are both smiling and they are happy. The dentist for the result that he gave to his patient, and the patient because he get rid of his denture that he was in his mouth for about 5 years. I was in the Corfu Island for several days when this surgery happened, and I met the patient after a week, and I asked him personally, how do you feel? What is the difference? Because I am not a dentist. as you can read in my CV, I'm not a dentist, but I would like to take the feedback of the patients so as to take the power and getting more motivated for what we are doing here in Greece. The patient answered to me that I got my smile back, I got my taste back, and finally I sleep with my teeth in my mouth. This is the best result and example, I believe, that a general dentist took all the advantages of digital dentistry and CAD/CAM dentistry and surgical guide dentistry and put all the advantages in his clinic that he hadn't ever before provided these solutions. The second case is from another dentist, Dr. Asikis Lazaros. He is in Veria City. He's an old user of Megazen implants. He started cooperating with us with the Easy Plus and the Rescue implants. And after he moved forward to the Anyrids implant system, and now he's using it mostly. And we decided to do a lot of cases the last 2 years more digital. And that's why, because not he was not capable to do the cases, but he wanted to move one step forward from all other dentists in the area, provide full guided surgical treatments and immediate provisionals to his patients. The first case that we did was about 2 years ago. It was a case with three, I think it was two implants, three element bridge, screw retained. It was a success. The patient was very happy. And from then, we started to do a lot of cases digitally. In this case, we have a female around 65 to 67. She had decided to make implants to a neighbor country, and the implant unfortunately was lost. We expected that there will be some bone loss in the upper jaw, and we let the patient gums heal so as to have a good in clinical situation, as you see in the photo, and we make a new implant treatment with Anyrids implants so as to have great initial stability and provide her an immediate provisional, because she was very disappointed with the implants that she had, and she was feeling embarrassed not being able to smile because of her teeth loss. As you can see, in this case, we again used the custom arthro tray, because there was only one tooth in the mouth, and we make the fitting. Always, we suggest to have a good CPCT and good custom tray, so we provide the dentist the custom trays, or if they produce themselves, we first examine the arthro trays, if the quality is good, if the fitting on the casted model is excellent. Then we check it in the CBCT, and then we proceed to the treatment plan. This is the digital WhatsApp that we get from the Exocad, so as to do a prosthetic drive and implant position in the mouth. And here we can see how we cooperate with dentists and how we work. We have the cast, we have the model of the initial situation of the patient. We overimpose the digital WhatsApp. We can see where are the screws, holes comes out, so as not to have to use multi-unit abutments if it's not necessary. and lowering the cost also of the prosthetics is one point of using the surgical guides. Even if you can place an implant, but the cost goes up because you have to use multi-unit abutments or a complex system, is something that we don't need. If we can find an ideal position that the use of an easy post or a CCM abutment or something cheap for the dentist, but always official from magazine, is our willing. We don't want to get a lot of money for our patients. We want for our customers. We want our customers to realize that by using the surgical guide, they minimize the metatraumatic period. For example, they don't have sutures, they don't have bleeding. They minimize the cost of the prosthetics. And of course, they get more predictable results. This is the point that we are getting with normalizing digital dentistry. As you can see, the files, this is the file that we get as a confirmation according to the digital WhatsApp, in combination with the best surgical position, because this patient didn't have a lot of bone in the upper jaw after the extraction and the failure of the previous implant. And we use the minimal invasive technique without making GBR or things like that. And we placed, and the dentist placed six implants in the most convenient positions so as to avoid GBR techniques. This is the Artware software. When we export the surgical guide, here we can design this surgical guide. These are the holes and the sleeves, and they're going to be the sleeves for our surgical guide, as you can see. And after extracting this file, you also have to print the surgical guide. This is the STL file that is exporting from the Artware software. As you can see the pins, and there are two pins. Also, there is a palatal support in this case, and a bar for supporting surgical guide. And in that case, we proceed to the printing of the digital model that came out of the Artware software. Here you can see the surgical guide fitting on the 3D printed model, and if you see a more detail in the holes, you can see the digital lab analog, the RP analogs. Because this was a very good case, and we have the time to do a lot of experimental on the 3D printing model, you can see that we also used an extra overlay for the soft tissue so as to choose the correct abutments. The dentist, Dr. Asikis, wanted to try the Octa system, so we have to choose the Octa according to the soft tissue height. Before going to choose the Octa abutments, I will show you how all STL files are perfectly merged. This is the initial STL file from the jaw of the patient. This is the provisional that we took from the lab. These are the scan abutments that came out from the Artware software. And this is the final STL file that we get for the surgical guide. As you can see, there is a perfect fit if you overlay one STL over the other. These are the so the next step was to choose the Octa abutments. We have the ExoCAD software for designing the provisional according to our scan abutment STL file that exporting from the Artware software. These are the SDL files and that are going to be produced from the ExoCAD software. As you can see on the left screen, we can see the holes or the scan abutment if you prefer that we have from the R2Gate software. And on the right screen, these are the holes that the temporary has to pass and be engaged in the mouth of the patient. The provisional that came from a CAD machine, after that, I think that the lab glazed them and they are ready to be delivered to the dentist. But before sending them to our customers, we also use an articulator to test them and see that there is no occlusal, so as not to have a lot of forces in the implants after the immediate loading. As you can see, the octa abutments here are shown because the lab has removed the gum. Everything was delivered to the dentist, the surgical guide, the provisionals, the octa abutments marked in the position. So, the day of the surgery, he just has to put this in the sequence into the mouth. Here is the surgical guide. As I mentioned before, we have used pins. We have used a large surface of the upper jaw to have the surgical guide supported. The dentist proceeds to the drilling. The drilling procedure is strictly coming out according to the bone density. And this is the fantastic thing with the R2Gate software, that you can calibrate any CBCT that you take from any unit to the bone density by using a unique protocol which is called Digital Eye. You can calibrate the whole CBCTs to the best values fitting the Hounsfield measurements. So if you have a D1 density bone, you have a different protocol. If you have a D2 or D3, D4, you take a different protocol for drilling. After the drilling, based on the the bone density, there was the implant positioning, and then comes the octa abutments. As you can see on the right side of the screen, one octa abutment was a bit bigger, the head was not the appropriate, but due to COVID situations, all the surgeries are not made in the time that was scheduled. So, probably the dentist will leave it as it is, or he has to change it in the second phase when he put the final prosthetics in the mouth. But all of this won't be seen when you get the temporary abutments into the mouth. As you can see, the temporary abutments were trimmed previously from the lab, so the dentist just place in their position, and then he fitted up the provisional. And this is, I believe, a very good result for provisionals the day of the surgery. And as you can see, the patient can smile directly. Imagine that he came without any teeth in her mouth, and he left after a 2.5 hour surgery with this result as a provisional. I believe that she was very happy, and after calling Dr. Asikis and asked him how it went. After every case, I called the dentist to see how the case went, because I want to take the feedback, how they felt, how the patient is, how everything was okay. Not for being very professional, but being very friendly to the dentist and to the patients, because who knows, I might be a patient one day to one of these dentists. From the same dentist, Dr. Asikis Lazaros, we had a lower jaw. As you can see, there are not a lot of teeth in the mouth. There are two canines, one molar, one third molar, and one premolar. The plan was using any ridge implant, immediate loading. In this case, there were three labs that was involved. One lab was digital aesthetic, Michalis Papastamos, for the surgical guide. Pantelis Xidas lab was for printing and making the digital RP analogs fitted into the 3D printing module. And the lab of Stratos Hadzihristos, who make the provisional. So as you can see, we don't collect everything to our R2 lab. We're just letting the dentist decide what he wants to do, to whom he wants to cooperate with, and always we have the surgical guide printed by our lab so as to have the best results and be confident that we did the best that we could do for that case. As you can see, this is the R2Gate planning again, the software. You can see the nerve, you can see the pins and the implants in the position. These are the files that he came out from the R2Gate again. This is the digital workshop that we had from the doctor's lab, Mr. Stratos Hadzihristos. And this is the digital workshop that we used into our software. And after finalizing and exporting the STLs, the STL files, this is the file that is created with the scan abutment. This file was sent to Pantelis Xidas lab, and he 3D printed the model for the RP analogs. Okay, this is the fitting, the provisional, and the RP analogs inside, as you can see. This was the file that was created. We put it into the ExoCAD software. We changed the scan abutments with the RP analogs. This is the file on the right that sees shows us how the implant should be in the mouth. We printed the model with the RP analogs and the octa buttons in position, so as the next lab can use this file and make the provisionals and trim and make the holes into the provisional denture. Indeed, this is the outcome of Stratos Hadzihristos lab. This is the provisional. We used also a little pink PMMA to cover the octa abutments or the holes that will be appeared in the mouth after the provisional restoration. Again, the guy tested that everything is okay before the surgery. And unfortunately, I don't have images from this surgical guide because Dr. Asikis Lazaros' assistant was not there to make some images. So I have only the final clinical image with the provisional in mouth. And that, as you can see, it's a very good job. And the result is very good. The patient came without any teeth in the lower jaw, and he left after 2.5-3 hours max with provisionals, and I think she was very happy. This is a different case. This is a patient around 55. It's a full upper jaw restoration. In the clinical image that I'm going to show you in the next slide, you can see that there was a partial denture. There were some periodontal teeth with metal ceramic grids. Here we used a reverse engineering. The immediate provisional came to the next day, as it was a very complex case. We placed implants into the extraction sockets, and in these cases we cannot be so sure if the position will be as we plant in the R2Gate software, because it happens once or twice in the extraction sockets. We imagine that the bone will be there, but the teeth moved a little bit, the bone, or the bone, the palatal bone was cracked and things like that. So the dentist, after our suggestion, decided to, okay, let's place the implants with a surgical guide from the R2Gate. Let's decide the abutments that we are going to use, and I will take a pickup impression and send it to the lab. But the lab had already pre-designed the provisional into the exocad, and then he adjusted so as to fit to our outcome. Let's see the case. As you can see, this is the image of the patient. From 13 to 22, he has a partial denture, and the other teeth was periodontal, as I already told you. This is the clinical after removing the partial denture. These are the periodontal teeth with the metal ceramic. I think that the two molars are the periodontal teeth, and the two first premolars are not. The teeth and the bridge after the extraction. As you can see, there was a lot of defect in the area, so it was not a small surgery. They have to clean all the extraction socket, use GBR, of course. The GBR was done with a PRF membrane in combination with bone. I think it was it was from human, 65 crestal, 35 soft bone, I don't remember exactly. And the method was mixing the PRF with the bone graft and make a sticky bone, place the implant and then cover it. If I don't remember exactly. This is the planning. As you can see, in this case, we decided to use the multi-unit abutments. There was one 70 degrees and one 29 degrees. The new multi-unit abutments that we have from Megazin, with less bone loss. It's an excellent design, no comparison with the previous one. And in the front teeth, we used octa abutments. We prefer the octa abutments than the multi-unit, because we believe that the mechanics from the straight multi-units, to be honest, the mechanic to support something on a one piece abutment is getting better results, and we don't give a lot of different components to our dentist. For example, the octa abutment is something common to those who want to use a one time one abutment concept. So the straight has been replaced from the octa, but I think that the 13 and the 14th number has multi-units angle abutment. And as you can see, this is the surgical guide. The surgical guide here, because of the complexity of the case, was teeth supported, as you can see. It was pin supported. There is one pin in the front and one pin, if I remember correctly, in the distal position of the surgical guide. We have palatal support and also a bar in the middle to keep it more easily to its position. Here we have another support after placing the implant in position of 15th with the anchor kit of Megazen implant system. You can add extra support to the surgical guide by fitting the metallic pin into the implant, which gives you better stability without using a lot of pins. Here are the clinical images after the implant placement. As you can see, the most damage was from the teeth extraction and not from placing the implants. Also, in the position of 15th, 16th, there was a GBR technique for bone regeneration. These are the pickup open tray system impressions. It was sent to the lab. The lab, who had already designed the provisional and the digital workshop for our case, adjusted the holes. As you can see, we didn't place at all multi-unit abutments, as the screws was not so difficult to get with the straight implants for the provisionals. Here is a design into the ExoCut from the lab, as you can see. And here is the provisional restoration, fully milled digital, designed digital, and fitted on the temporary abutments. The surgery took place, if I remember correctly, on Thursday afternoon, and the provisional was delivered on Friday morning. So under 24 hours, this is the clinical image of the patient next day morning. As you can see, even you have the extraction, and you, because of the usage of the PRF, the healing is very good. And as you can see, it's a great result for one day implant surgery. And this is the first case that we did here in Greece with Dr. Michalis Markatis. All the digital and the provision was from digital aesthetic Michalis Papastamos. I think that already passed 2.5 years, as Facebook reminded me a few months earlier. And this was where I realized all the benefits of the digital dentistry. I have seen a lot of videos, I participate to a lot of seminars, I was in a lot of congresses promoting and showing the digital dentistry benefits and how we can get it in our normal everyday life, and the dentist can take all the benefits. But to be honest, it's very different to see in a live action taking place, placing the implants from a surgical guide that you have designed, fitting the teeth that your partner has designed in the same day, and having a dentist very, very, very satisfied, but most important, to have after 2.5 hours a patient like her smiling, and even if she paid a lot of money, she was very thankful to the dentist. So for me, normalizing digital dentistry and giving your patient a one-day smile is the most important thing of digital guided surgeries. Before I thank you all, and because we are in a COVID situation, just keep in mind that we have to stay safe, Please read the following message. I don't want to read it for you. I want to thank you for being responsible to each other. I hope that we are going to show you, me and other colleagues from around Greece, a lot of cases. But in order to do that, we have to stay safe. We have to be taking care of ourselves and from people, for our people who are low. So use the digital dentistry every day. Make it your normal dentistry, as you can earn time, less chair time for your patient. You can provide them the best services that you can with your partners and your labs. And stay safe, take care, protect yourselves and others. Thank you very much for your attention, and I hope that you got my point that everybody can take the benefits of surgical guided surgeries, of digital prosthetics, and from digital planning into everyday normal dentistry. From a simple oral dental surgeon to, as you can see, a periodontal professors, everybody. Digital is here, and you have to take all the benefits. You have to use it, and we have to use it as we use our cell phones. Thank you very much. Take care. Bye-bye.